Hey guys, how's it going? Cuba coming again. Welcome back to another video. As you guys can see, it says right there, Archaeology is finally here. I'm sorry if I sound very ratty or something. Just woke up. It is 6:04 in the morning. Archaeology came out 4 minutes ago. I wanted to be one of the first people to just get on it and get going. So video is actually going to be the tutorial of it. So there is no nude quest, but it is directing me over there. There's a talk to this person. I don't know if that's what you call an elite skill or not. Oh. Nice little cold. Or fame and story. Gotta uncover this soil right here. Give me soil right there. I don't know if you guys can see.
I can find it all across.
Okay, so I think I want to go until the blue bar is done.
I hit level 2! Yes!
There is. I'm going to look that up while this is going. RS3. I got, oh, we got somebody there with 5,000 XP.
My crew is going.
Okay, so when excavating, you can make discoveries. These damaged artifacts are discovered can be absorbed, but they're
required.
Gives me. I need 5 imperial iron and 5 purple wood hardened.
The soil that I get, I looks like I can actually read it. I get more material from it. I have the iron, and I just need one more. Oh, bless me. Whew. This is one wild morning already. Storage container where I can put all my materials. All right, artifacts, so that's cool. Stuff with that. That's awesome. Different. I don't know if I've been able to be heard the entire time, but we'll see. Video. Her. Oh, there's a collector information board. Valuable. So if I click tribute. Mortal cup. I can talk to him. So I think now this is where I'm gonna get the ability to use the mysterious monolith, which can give you stuff such as wants me to go to the monolith, but this will give me abilities such as, like, the one that's really cool that I want to get is whenever you go into the abyss, it actually can teleport you straight to the middle, or you can get like XP buffs and all that. So on the map, monolith. This is what I got. These are the relics. Relics are freaking amazing. They have so much stuff they can do. So the relic that you get right away is the font of life. It increases your maximum health by 500. So I'm pretty sure the health that you can only go to is 9900. But now this one will bring it up to 4000, I think. 11,400. That sounds 10,400. That's how much. Yeah. Click it. And so these chronotes are also like the currency of this. It's how you use this one. Let me find it. When converting memories at a rift, you convert your entire backpack in one go. Like, they're just so cool. When running, you would no longer drain your run energy. That will actually be really cool. One I really liked. When woodcutting, you always burn your cut logs for immediate fire making. That is gonna harness it. And you can have three of them on it. Okay, so now I guess I'm meeting him. Talk to him again. Quick tour. There's a map right here that six sites, and I may actually use it for. I get new qualifications. I can purchase them. Had done a bunch of chronos. Should I purchase anything for now? There's that. Let's go buy a soil box. What this shop has to offer. So with show notes. Really increases your chance of finding materials. So these actually looks like they are temporary. Yeah, these are temporary things. And once you are a guild master, as I've answered the qualifications, everything you need to be out there start excavating. The final thing is to give. Intern. I have started. So, I get the soil box, restores 50 of each soil, access to Guildmaster's office, access to intern reward, archaeology, intern title, and journal. So, let's read the journal. Oh, so he's instantly taking me over to the first dig site. So, perfect. I guess I'm not done. This fort to help answer some of Gilnor's oldest mysteries. Let me take you on a quick tour of what we have around here. So another tour. So yay. Sorry, I just needed to move my mic. Workbench. It's rich in silk. There's no artifact as we can tell, but it is rich in material. Artifacts do seem to be on and out here, though. You should be able to find plenty. Cool, cool. Ooh, I can get into a fort. Traps. Alright, so I'm just gonna go excavate something. But otherwise, I believe that is actually the end of the tutorial. I believe I can just start to uncover everything now. There's a bunch of different stuff there, so now it's just gonna be a grind of getting to all that. Now that I uncovered it, I gotta excavate it. That would be annoying also. That's amazing. Some people are such a high level already. I don't even know how. I say high, but they're really not that high of a level. Mortal Cub. So yeah, I got a bunch of that stuff. That's cool. Alright. So, go and clear it and see, like, what happens. Oh, I need level 12. Okay. I'm hoping maybe I can find another. Probably going to be at the end of this video. Thank you so much for watching. I hope to have this out as soon as possible for you people that are not able to jump on or might even want to come back to RuneScape. Archaeology. If you enjoyed the video, please give it a like, comment, and subscribe to see more videos on RuneScape and a bunch of other games. So thank you so much, and I will see you next time.